Okay, so not exactly what I planned for the first episode, but this is my digital equipment corporation, I think that's at least the name of it. PDP 1123. I got this secondhand from someone on the local Kijiji, which came with a bunch of nice little data cassettes. But the reason I'm doing this video is, quite frankly, this thing kind of went a bit crazy the other day. While I'm moving this, getting ready, I'll just let you know. So, the other day, about a week ago now, I was woken up, because this used to be in my room, but we moved it out, because I was woken up by my girlfriend in the middle of the night, and she said something's going on with the computer, me being half asleep, because I'll sleep through a thunderstorm, didn't know what she was talking about. This just comes off. Ooh, what's this? But yeah, me not knowing what the heck she was talking about, because I will sleep through almost anything, was like, oh, okay, what are you talking about? Then I realized this thing was turning on and off and on and off and on and off ridiculously fast and seemed to be glowing. So, see? Okay, any electricity that wasn't there has seemed to have discharged. Sorry it's a bit shaky cam, but kind of the best. As I said, not really my original plan, but it is what it is. This is not the cleanest of rooms. You can see a typewriter, Commodore TV that's about to be dismantled and torn apart and thrown out because of a failed project. But yeah, so this is my device, and you're just going to come with me as I try and work out what the heck was going on. Okay, the whole thing's going to be a bit shaky cam, as you can guess. So I'll just put you there, and yeah, this is probably going to be edited together after the fact, so sorry about the audio, sorry about the video quality. This kind of wasn't originally planned, but I thought might as well get this done. So here we go, let's try and open this thing up. Okay. One thing I like about this is this little lock is like this Allen key thing. So you're just gonna turn that, voila, opens. Then you've got this foamy thing. Yeah, I'm gonna move this door to the side and hopefully figure out what, if anything, was going on. So let's like that again. Let's just pull this down. There. So this is the back panel of a PDP 1123. Sadly, I don't have an actual user manual for this thing, mostly because I haven't been able to find one so far. But this is what it is. Let's just this. Yeah, this is kind of a weird, mostly boring kind of video. Because this is purely me just trying to work out what the heck was going on, see if it's still doing the same old nonsense kajugle what's it. Let's just pull these out here. Let's see if I can get a decent shot. I don't have a tripod with me right now, so let's just, yeah, I'm probably committing cardinal sins of computing here, but right now, I'm more focused on getting this sorted out. Let's see if the light will work. Oh, that actually helps. So, let's just put that one there. Yeah, stuff did seem to come off. So let's get all of these cables undone. Hopefully without electrocuting me. Please. Please, computer. Beth. Okay, let's see. I thought now's a good time to do it, because this way, one, there's not too much noise in the house. Two, as far as I know, Home Alone. Which, one, is kind of bad, because if this does go horribly wrong and decides I'm going to shock this weird English-Canadian person, then there's not really anyone here to help me. But on the other side of the coin, there's not too much noise, so I guess not too bad. So yeah, this is the back panel. This device is a sub-assembly of in the context of the FCC rules. Blah 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 blah. Technical nonsense. Bit of information. Oh, buddy, that's a decent amount of power. So what I've got here is I've got a. I can't talk at the moment. Apparently, I've got a the data cassette reader, as well as the main board, plus a couple nice expansions, and this card which hasn't been connected because I disconnected it, because this thing keeps giving me a pretty bad, like a boot error. When you start it up, you see those little LEDs there. Just try and zoom in. Those little LEDs, you've got a power one, and I think this is just another diagnostic, a couple more diagnostic ones. And they just kind of tell you what's wrong. And by my understanding, which is shaky at best and possibly very wrong, of the information I found, that the code I keep getting means there's a boot error. But let's disconnect that. Disconnect that guy. I'm not seeing any melting marks so far. Sorry for my shaky hands. But no melted kind of pins. So it doesn't seem too bad. There is a bit of discoloration around there. Almost implies it was heated up recently. Let's, thing is, this is full of capacitors, so I'm just scared to kind of touch that. Where's that screwdriver? Let's see if, okay, so any power would have, in theory, already bled out, but let's also disconnect that. While I'm doing this, I'll just say a little bit more. So, when this thing was going haywire, I really didn't know what to do. So, me being probably the biggest idiot in the world right about now, let's see if that'll go there nicely, maybe. Just got to do a screw down here. Me being a bit of an idiot, decided, oh, let's touch the machine that's shorting out, or whatever was going on. So, I touched it, and by touched it, I mean I hit the power switch on the front of this main unit, and I dropped the thing that goes into. That's easy to get back. Let's pull out this board. My thumb is a bit sore. It doesn't look too bad. But yeah, so I'm just going to pull out this unit. It's just disconnected. Good, good, good. Let's just close some of these. Sorry, I'm just going to close these off the side, probably here we go like that. I have a lot of old junk, so this is kind of, welcome to my first episode, I guess, I don't know what you call this, I don't even know if this will go on the internet, but if I went on the internet, I'd probably get loads of people telling me, you're doing this wrong, you're doing this wrong. Shush. Right, I don't know if anyone's going to be here, so if this tape captures my death, I've had a good life. Love you all. Love my friends. Everything I own gets split up between my girlfriend and my family. Figure it out. Sell anything that's of any value that no one wants. That, you know, the usual stuff. Die doing what I love, I guess. We don't know if that's true. Right. Yeah, what I was going to try and show you. I'm going to try and. Do not remove screws for service. Danger, high voltage, present on power supply components. So, let me just show you. Gosh, I hate setting this up badly. Oh, gosh. Yeah, see, you might be able to see in here fans and capacitors. And well, upon first inspection. Oh, I'm zooming in, sorry about that. It doesn't look too bad, to be honest. I'm not seeing any major burning. I seem to be okay to hold down there. So, as I said earlier, if I die, you know, usual. I'm just saying that because I don't know what was going on. So I'm doing this rather unsafely, I guess, but with what I have. So, come on. Okay, okay. Remember, kids, don't play with sharp metal. It hurts. I can say that because I'm an adult. Apparently, whoever decided to make me an adult is an idiot. Right, so here we are. His main board. Also suffering a little bit of a cold, so sorry for
a bit nasally voice if it happens.
Actually, I'm going to try something. Give me a sec, and... Okay, let's try this. Found my tripod. Let's see, let's try and just get this shot decent enough. Okay, I should be able to see from here. So, welcome to the main board of a PDP 1123. As I've said, and I'm going to keep saying, what I'm doing isn't the best. Always make sure you're properly grounded and all that. But for the record, when I got this thing, didn't seem to boot up properly anyway, but I'm just gonna pull out these. They just kind of come out like that. Easy peasy. So yeah, from my understanding, you've got a nice little CPU there. Or is that the CPU? Anyway, yeah, this is how little I know about this system. It's beautiful, isn't it? I can't really find how to properly set these up. If anyone's watching who knows, please let me know. Oh, let's see. If you look at those LEDs, they look like there's a bit of burnt around them, but I don't know if that's just the dust with the age of this thing. But regardless, that's the main board. Let's put you there for now. Now, the guy I got this from said it has, if I recall, a 5K memory expansion bay, which I believe he was saying was this. Made in Hong Kong. Okay, can't really find anything of importance, but yeah. So, looking around it, all there is all this dust. Look at all that dust. That is like 20 odd years of just... Ugh. Okay, more boards. Now the thing is, I'm not entirely sure what this board does. All I know is that it connects on the back through one of these guys. See if I can disconnect this for another second. It connects kind of to this panel here. It connects to one of those ports around there, which are kind of the same as the ones that this guy connects to, so I think it might just be an expansion system. Now let's pull that out. So yeah, you've got nice port. Look at the workmanship on these. They don't make them like they used to. Oh, hang on, what's this? Okay. Starting to see something here that I don't know if this is just the age, because I never actually had a good look at it, but if you look at these, get a good close up. Come on, autofocus, there we go. I don't know if that's just dust or if that's from the little sparky spark thing that happened the other day. Hopefully it's just dust, because... Or it's a coating. I know like nearly nothing about these boards, but I'm just going to put you here on the table. Right, so then let's open this up and pull this one out. And that's the final board, just like the other one. Let's put you there as well. Right, so again, going for a little trip. Let's just try and get a good shot. So this is the computer bay. Nice little simple VOD system. And then you've got the connectors, kind of like, again, I know like not enough about this kind of stuff, but they're like the cartridge connectors on old NES or 64, that kind of stuff, or Commodore VIC 20. But yeah, then besides, you've got this port here. That port connects to, let's turn the light back on, this wire. This wire then runs all the way down to the power supply and all the dustiness that's down there. Disgusting, I know. But that cable runs up and it allows you to control a system. Move that tripod, come down to here, control the system from these switches, from this power switch specifically. Nice sounding switch. Halt, restart, halt, run, aux on, off. I am zoomed in so much there, sorry for that. Just nice little switches, kinda nice sound to them, good quality. Anyway, right, so one thing I found online was an idea of just running it basics. So that's when you would have got this out of the box, from my understanding, you would only have this board. So what I'm going to do, put that in, hopefully, please, come on. Okay, then close that up. Okay, so that's now forced in place. That's gonna hold, hopefully. Let's see if this will come to here. Right, it will. I'm gonna do something now, which is probably a very stupid idea. Turn that off. Turn that to remote local on down here. And then, okay, that's not the cable I want. I want power cable. Now, if we look at the power cable, okay, power cable, dusty, maybe a little paint on it, but I'm not really seeing any signs of fire damage. So, let's do something very stupid. So I'm going to use the faraway plug for this, so if this does go horribly wrong, I can just probably quickly, sorry, the cable's wrapping right against the tripod. It's just... Okay, so power supply is now on. I'm going to show you that quickly. There was a bit of a click, and you see that light. Maximum total current, 12 amps on all outlet, for all outlets. Okay, so that's running. Now, let's try. Oh, I can't even hit the switch hard enough. Come on. There we go. So that's on. But all those lights are on. So I think it was a boot test or something. I'm going to put this back in its little holder. Just keep an eye on everything. And so just leave that a little bit and see what happens, if anything. Let's see if I can find that file. Okay. So yeah, those lights are staying on, which I'm really hope. Oh, I know what it is. I know what it is. I made a mistake. Okay, just gonna show you this quickly. So those lights are all on. But if we go around to the front, you can see power OK light is on, but the halt light is off. Okay, the run light is off. Sorry, so it's halted. Set this switch out of halt into run. Restart. Okay, so the run is just flashing on and off, and only one of those LEDs is on. So let's try turning off the entire system. So the LEDs aren't burnt out, which is a good thing. Let's try turning this all on. again. Okay. So run is not activated. See if I hit restart. Turn off halt. Run is only flashing on for a moment. So power indicator's on. And the... Again, sorry for the noise. And the and one of the diagnostic lights is on. So let's just keep a nice little zoom in on that. Wow. Oh, look! I think I found it, actually. What's this? Processor for PDP 1104, 34A, 44, 60, 70. No! That's not what I need! Let's try PDP 1123. Halting every instruction. Let's see if this is the one that I found a while ago. Attached images. Oh, that's what I need. Yeah, welcome to how well thought out all of this is. What's wrong? Oh, thank you for logging in. Fantastic. Okay, so that's not the board I'm looking for. Lovely. Let's see. No, back, please. 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 Please work. Okay, so that's of the CPU and sync cards just in case the actual strips of switches. This, no. Nope, that's not what I'm looking for. Okay, P11 plus. I found the manual a while ago, but the thing is, I can't seem to find it again. No. Oh. LSI 11 systems service manual. What though? What are you for? 11? Oh! +1123. Oh, fantastic! Okay, so let's go forward. Actually, no, let's do this. Let's download this. So it's still only on that. Okay. Come on. Raster graphics system for the VS-11. Right. Well, this has been useful as all heck. What the heck is joystick? Lovely. That's what I'm looking. Right, okay. I'm going to come back to that, but overall, looking at the system, it's not blowing up, it would seem at least. So let's just turn that off for now and let that completely turn off. Maybe I could get away with unplugging that as well. My lovely cable technique. I'm joking, of course. Follow all instructions properly and all that. So let's try putting the 5K memory back in. See if that'll be any help to anything. I mean, it would be great if this thing had just come with a manual. But no, the guy I got it from, they got it from the guy who owned the house they moved into and all that kind of stuff. But he was telling me there was all of this computer stuff in the house that they just threw out. And I was like, really? No! Why? Why would you do that? But anyway, that's not mine to judge. Okay, so again, turn it on and only the one light is on. Which I personally, I'm still trying to work out what the heck that means. So let's see if I can find that out and I'll cut to it with any luck. This looks like the actual manual. Please be in English. Oh yeah. Okay. Okay, yeah, this is it. Let's copy the diagnostics. Yep, save that. Download, please. Okay, opened up. Continue scroll. Fantastic. Continue. Born in the US with Mac Mini. This is for me. Okay, getting started. This is looking like the system, all right. I guess it's a 23 plus. It is. Oh, okay. So there's two lights on now, which is different. Guess that's good. Optional feature: break key function. Okay. Load, run, stop, ready. I don't have that disk drive. I don't have that cartridge. I wish I had that cartridge though. That's a... Well, that looks like a nice system. But right, okay, testing, changing disk cartridge. Oh, where is it? Programming. No. No. This is all what to do when the system's running. This isn't what to... Bitch, keep doing. Installation and troubleshooting. How to exit, how to get it out of the box. Oh, lovely. But it's not in the box. Also, it doesn't have half the stuff. So yeah, this was definitely secondhand. Power control on the lower front panel. Circuit breaker, IO cable, terminator. I wish I had all this stuff. I don't. But this is definitely what I'm looking for. Awesome. The KDF 11B LEDs. And let's turn on the flashlight on here. Oh, let's not drop you. Okay, so it doesn't have the LED. So it's not entirely the plus system. It's not the PDP 11 plus. But, what's that? KDF 11B. Don't even know where to find that information. Okay, don't know where to find that information. But! Let's go on the assumption that. Yeah, this isn't a very good tutorial. This is me smagging around, just mucking around and seeing what will happen. What's this?
PDP 1123B subsystem. Okay, so this is how to wind it all up. Use the proper keyboard. Oh, I wish I had all this stuff, it was so awesome. Even just a VT1000 system, that would be beyond amazing. Okay, so turn up the halt and on-off switches. Okay. But I don't need to do the off switch because the power's already running. Flip the restart switch. The restart switch always spins back down. The drive should click and the run light on. CPU's come on. This means the CPU is working. Okay. Turn the hard switch up and you're now ready to run the checkout disk. Flip the restart switch and the drive should click and the run light on. The CPU should come on. Oh wait, what was the board number? Board number...
Okay, so, what I've been able to work out, I'm zooming there since it's... So I'm going to get my finger on, off, on. Apparently, if I'm reading this correctly, that means, well, it's 101 binary, that's on off on. And in octal, that's 5. And according to this, 5 means it's a boot device error. Which could mean anything wrong with, well, this. With any luck, it's just dirty. Let's see. Console, I don't know. Okay. Boot device status error. So hopefully, let's go up the airboard again. Hopefully, that's just an error. With that, I think that's the CPU list. Hopefully that is just the error. Or maybe these are wrong, because I don't really understand those properly. Yeah, so that's, other than that, it seems to be working properly. It's not going haywire and trying to kill me anymore, which was kind of spooky. Yeah, so all this seems to be running. It's just... Okay, so the run light actually comes on now. Let's see if that'll stay going. Let's keep the... Maybe turn on the light. Okay, so yeah, what's that octal? Binary, it's 2, I choose, 2, octal, it's 2, that's the octal. 2, either halt memory test, okay, so doing a memory test, the memory test then comes back saying there's a boot device status error. So yeah, right now, that's all I can do, and I'm guessing the light's turned off. Okay, so the test was complete. Right now, I can't really do much else, because I keep having problems when I try to use the, what's it called? When I try to, plug it into a terminal on my desktop, so I'm going to have to try and figure out that nonsense before I can start trying to figure out, because it should spit out to a computer terminal, but it isn't at the moment. So I'm just gonna pack this all up. Probably put it all back in, but not wire up everything. This is just gonna kind of sit at the moment as a sitting, standing, waiting for information kind of setup. But yeah, so that's that for now. If you did watch and you know anything, please let me know if there's anything I should know. If you think I'm an absolute klutz, then please tell me. That's it, really. Thanks for watching.